The dot on the right, yeah, right. Okay. Hey guys!
What's going on, YouTube?
Sorry. Okay.
What's up?
It's
Cam
and Katie. Cam and Katie Redmond now.
So, we decided to make another vlog. We realized that this is only our second vlog because the first one was kind of our introduction, talking about us. And then we did another one where it was kind of a sit down and talking, but it was like a, more like one of those challenge videos. It wasn't like just us.
Yeah, the Irish slang one.
Yeah, the slang one. So we realized that this is pretty much our second vlog where it's just us kind of talking about our lives and what's going on right now.
Yep.
We thought that this is the perfect time to do it because we just moved to
Spain!
I thought you were going to say Spain.
I know.
Our first place. And yes, just so you know, I carried Caitlin over the threshold.
That was for my mom.
We'll add the video. Not for your mom, that was tradition.
I know, but that my mom kept saying it, and I feel like my mom should know.
Regardless of Laurie, I would have carried you over the threshold because it's tradition.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Welcome to our family, baby.
Oh my gosh, it's big.
Welcome to our first place, baby.
I love it. It's perfect.
I love you.
I love you.
So, a lot of people have been asking us why Spain, what has you guys in Spain? Very confusing because everyone was, you know, the hype was all about Caitlin coming to Ireland from America and living with me there. And now that we're here in Spain, everyone's like, that's a switch up. So,
yeah. Kind of random, but we want to do kind of a story time video. We are going to tell the story of how we ended up in España.
España.
You were thinking the same thing.
I heard you go, so I was like, España. So, little backstory. My family own an apartment here. That's why, in the end, we end up coming here. But to tell you how we got the apartment, very quickly. In 2000, my granddad died on my mom's side, passed away. And when that happened, my grandmother decided that she would move over here to Spain. She had her very close friends were living here. Her best friend, Evelyn, was living here. And she decided she'd move over here to be with them and that she'd work here for a year and just kind of get away from Ireland because obviously it was hard on her, you know. So she bought a place here. Then moved back to Ireland, and ever since then it's been like a holiday / vacation destination for my family and for, you know, aunties and uncles and stuff, and we've all been using it. But recently my mom bought it from my grandmother because she's been trying to sell it. And with the use we had of it, we'd come here at least once a year. My mom was like, well, we might as well take it. So, about a month and a half before our wedding, I was here with my family, and at the time me and Caitlin were really starting to talk about where we would live and you know, getting
a month before our wedding. Just think about that. You're a month before your wedding, you're still planning your wedding. Actually, not just a wedding, four weddings, because we had so many wedding celebrations, and now we're discussing where we're gonna live because that's how we roll.
Yeah, we left it to the last minute.
Like, no. We always do.
What we've always said is, what we've always noticed is that we are very blessed. And everything about our life has always just clicked and everything's just fit perfectly.
Mm-hmm.
And so because of that, we've kind of gotten into a tendency of not really stressing about stuff, which is a good thing because stress is
not good. Not that we just figure, oh, things are just going to work out for us, but just in a way of if we focus on what we need to right now,
yeah,
the future is going to come in place. Like, yeah. Obviously you have to work for what you have. The Lord doesn't just give you everything that you want, but with so many things, so many big things happening in a row, we just figured let's focus on the wedding, Let's focus on the time we have together as we visit each other. And then we'll have the faith that wherever we're supposed to live will fall into place.
We kind of just took it a step at a time. Because we're both not really stressful people, so we just don't get too worked up. We focus on the here and now, and mm-hmm. things in the future we'll figure it out when they come. So that's kind of the perspective we had. So we really did leave finding a house or an apartment till the last minute. And so anyway, when I was here with my family, my mom kind of said to me, what about living here? Because at the time me and Caitlin were talking about how we were going to figure it out, where we'd live. You know, we really need to start looking for a place. Our wedding was a month away. And so my mom knew what was going on, and she said, well, what about living here? And I'd always seen this as a holiday destination, kind of a getaway. Every time I was here, I kind of felt out of place, so to speak. Like, we didn't have Wi-Fi, our phones don't work when we're here.
And in the back of your head, you know, I'll be going home in 2 weeks. Yeah, I'll be going home in a week.
We don't ever come here for short periods of time.
You look forward to coming here, but you look forward to going home as well.
Especially because, you know, mine and Caitlin's relationship was a lot of texting and calling, so when my phone didn't work while I was here, that was really tough. So I kind of just had a negative feeling about it, about this place, and the thought of living here just didn't, you know, even though it's beautiful and it's a great place for vacations or holidays, I never thought of actually living here. So when my mom said it, I was like, nah, like, I couldn't see myself. So she talked to me about it, and she said, well, you know, you could get this figured out, get that figured out, and it would become more of a homely place rather than a holiday place. And so I kind of mentioned it to Caitlin on the phone that night, later on that night when I had Wi-Fi.
But then we kind of just brushed it off, like, oh, that's an idea.
Yeah, or that could be
that would be nice. Yeah. We'll have to talk about it later, type of thing.
And then so Caitlin came over about 2.5 weeks before the wedding. And the day she came, we went and had our interview for our marriage license. We had to get an interview done because Caitlin was in Irish to make sure she wasn't just using me to get into Ireland. But anyway, so things started to get real then, you know? Like, we were getting our marriage license. Our wedding was 2 weeks away. Things were really starting to hit the fan, you know? So we started really discussing what we were going to do about a living choice. And we're actually on the bus home from getting our license. And I said to her, well, you know, like we discussed before, Spain is an option. Mm-hmm. It's right by the beach. It's a beautiful place. And because Caitlin loved California so much, I was like, it's kind of like the California of Europe. You know, it's always warm. It's always nice weather. And so we both kind of just got like this boost of positivity. And we were like, let's do it. Like, it'll be an adventure. It'll be fun. It'll be a great growing experience for us to just go off into the world on our own.
Yeah.
And so we got really excited about it. And so we decided that's what we'd do, kind of in that moment. It was a very quick decision, but we just said, this will be fun, let's go do it. You know, having the faith that obviously things would work out and we'd figure it out along the way. So the more we discussed it, the more it just clicked, the more it really did make sense to make that decision. Even though we had made it so quickly, the more we talked about it, the more we're like, actually, yeah, this is best. One of the first things we talked about was kind of, you know, making our relationship more equal. Caitlin was making such a big adjustment to move from America to Ireland, leaving her family and friends behind. That was a big deal for her. And then I was just living in Ireland where I'd always lived, you know. So it wasn't that it was unfair or made our relationship not equal. But at the same time, you know, there'd be days when she really missed home and I just never experienced that, you know, which isn't totally fair.
And the advice we've gotten from so many people are, you know, stay away from family and friends for a bit, be on your own the first few years of marriage, because that's when you truly get to know each other and you just learn so much about each other. We definitely have. So much of us.
True. So so the thought of that was both just going off on our own, being independent and really having to depend on each other and no one else. It just clicked. Just made sense. We're just like, yeah. And so the more we talked about it with people, we told my parents, we told Caitlin's parents, then we started to, when people ask, like, okay, so where are you going to live after you get married, we start telling people we're actually going to go live in Spain. And everyone we spoke to about it is like, that's a great idea. Like, you guys just getting away on your own, just like Caitlin said, you know, there's nothing better than your first few years of marriage to just get out and be on your own and travel and all those good things. So with that, we decided to contact my granny's friends that lived here, because they're good family friends, Ray and Evelyn. sent him a quick email and I said, hey Ray, Caitlin and I are thinking about living in the apartment for a few years, we're not sure yet, but we're kind of seeing how it goes. Do you have any advice? Would you recommend it? Like, do you know of any possible job opportunities in the area? Like, you know, kind of just looking for some advice, I guess, from someone who was already here. And straight away he was like, I have a job for you. You know, that was almost immediately like a confirmation to us that this was a step in the right direction, because there was a job straight away.
Right, because that was the biggest thing, is jobs for us. We're like, we can't, because we've gone without a job for so many months with all of our travels. So it was a huge blessing when that happened.
Yeah, it was. So so we kind of just took that as like almost a sign that like this was good for us. And then again, Caitlin is very capable of whatever she puts her mind to. And so Ray, our friend Ray, kind of said, well, what about Caitlin? What's she hoping to do? And we talked about some different things that Caitlin enjoys doing and has talents in. And he said there's, you know, he had even more options for her too. And so we were really excited. We said, all right, let's do it. And so that was it. We kind of made that decision. We got married. Then we went on our honeymoon. Check out our honeymoon vlogs. Then after our honeymoon, we went to Utah for a few days, well, for 2 weeks, had our wedding celebration there.
Yeah.
Went home to Ireland, spent a few days in Ireland, just 3 or 4 days.
Switch up! Sorry. Our camera keeps turning off right when we get to a certain amount of minutes, so we'll have to start from where we...
It's frustrating.
So
anyway, so we went home to Ireland, packed up, came here to Spain. And now we're living here, so.
Yeah. It's been an adventure, all right. Mm-hmm. So anyway, we're going to travel a lot while we're here, because it's a great central place to be able to go visit, you know, Italy and just a ton of different countries. I don't know, I say Italy because that was one of my favorite places on our Mediterranean cruise. But yeah, we would love to do a video of an apartment tour, or, you know, the day in the life of Spain, where we show you the beach and just around where we live. And we have a lot to show you guys, so we're excited. But we just wanted to do this update and story for you guys, and we're excited to see what comes the next few months here in Spain.
Yeah, when we're on our cruise for our honeymoon and we're in like the likes of Pisa and Rome, I was saying to Caitlin, like, when we're living in Spain, this will only be a few hours away, so we definitely want to make the most out of our first few years of marriage and travel and get to see places, you know, before we start really settling down and having kids. And then, you know, it'll be a few years before we can do it with them too, but...
That's so crazy. We're going to have kids together. Yeah, we'll live up the, you know, young love life first before kids, but...
Yeah. So anyway, but yeah, we will be traveling. We do it like we were saying, you know, Barcelona is only a few hours away from here, Madrid, you know, even the likes of Italy and France are just a drive away now that we're living here in mainland Europe. So, but yeah, lots more videos to come of where we're living, the beach, the area. You know, we're going to be vlogging a lot more now that we're kind of settled down, and we're going to be uploading more. Up to this point, our videos have kind of been like, look at what we're doing, but now we want to make it a lot more intimate and just like talking and really letting our personality show, if that makes sense. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So we're excited. We've got a beautiful camera from my brother for our wedding gift. So that's really enabled us to really start taking this whole vlogging thing seriously. Mm. And so we're really excited, because I think that was our biggest holdback, was that we didn't have like a proper camera and we're just using phones and stuff. Everyone says, like, when you get started, use an iPhone and stuff, but, you know, if you don't hold the phone a certain way, the screen's smaller.
As you'll see in our honeymoon videos, you know. But, so, yeah, the other camera we had that we filmed on our first vlog, it's a nice camera, but it's meant for pictures, pictures only. It's a great camera, but this one's great for vlogs and great for more professional photos as well. So, we're excited. Anyway... Thanks for watching.
Make sure to subscribe.
Yes, subscribe for more. We're going to at least once a week. We promise one video at least once a week.
Yeah.
So.
And so there'll be more to come. Comment below if there's anything specific, you know, you want to see, like Caitlin said earlier, any specific videos you'd like to see. But yeah, make sure to subscribe, because not only will we be doing more vlogs where we kind of just chat and talk about things, we'll do some challenges and some traveling, and we're definitely gonna make the most out of this whole YouTube experience, so we're excited.
And want to get to know you guys too. And don't forget to follow our Instagram, Cameron and Katie, because yes, Cam and Katie was taken, so we put out his full name. Sorry. Karate chop.
Bruh.
Put on his whole name, but it's still Cam and Katie for the name, so you'll find us. So anyway, peace out.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe.